Interesting quotes you are going to see now, based on my book, Palestinians in Torah Code, a book which really explains the ideological conflict between Israel and Palestinians in the past and today, definitely. The Philistine in the past and today connection is only spiritually, as we call today, the shells, the clipot, and it is shown by the fact that they are attracted to Gaza, to the old places. So spiritually, there is connection between the Philistine in the past and Palestinian today. So therefore, to understand exactly the roots, the source of these conflicts all over history, in fact, we suffered for the Palestinians already from the time of our forefathers. Yes, you know, the story with Isaac, Jacob. So, very interesting, significant table that you are going to see. Really was done with Professor Alec from Gander Center University in New York. That with him we did a lot of books. You can see our books, and this one in Kindles. You can see it at Amazon.com or in my site, GlazersonBooks.com. So what we have now in this tables. So it's the following. This is really what you have in the book. This is really taken from the site of Professor Alec, TorahCode.us. And this is what he explains here about the Philistines. The land of the Philistines is called Pleshet. This is to understand why Pleshet appears here, Philistia. It is an area which includes what is now called the Gaza Strip, plus the areas containing the cities of Ashkelon, Gaza, Ekron, Gaza, and Ashkelon. We pair the keyword Philistia with the keyword Samael. You know, this is the evil force, heavenly angel of the Amalekite. And the keyword Rav, it is another evil force. It is known to do more with Egypt, with the Arabs, the ministering angels of Israel and Ishmael, this is what we said, for the keywords Philistia and Samael with the expected number of ELS, equal letter sequence and set to under the probability that a text from the ELS random placement text population would produce a text as area compact as that produced by the Torah text is 14.5 to 10,000, which is about 1.5 to 1,000, which is significant. So this is really the table, unbelievable, you see how it intertwined together, Pleshet, together with the evil force, Samael, which is a, if you remember, this really the evil force, Samael, which comes to 131, is exactly the same inner gematria of the letters Gaza, Aza. This is what I found. Then there is another table which Professor Ibs did, showing also the Plishtim, the Philistines, with Hamas. Yeah, Hamas today represents these Philistines. See. And then you have another thing which Professor Aralik did. This is when you see Azav is an evil force, a heavenly minister of Ishmael, to do with Ra. So one of the most active centers of activity of the people Ishmael against the people of Israel in the Gaza. Therefore, it is natural to pair the keyword Gaza with Ra, the ministering angel of the people of Ishmael, and so to pair Gaza with Samael, or the Samael who is a end of days work with Rav against the people of Israel. The pairing of Gaza with Rav produces a statistically significant result, setting the expected number of ELS equal to a single of 40, that produced by the Torah text is 11 to 1,000, it is 1,200. So this is what you see here. And there is another one in the book, which is really to do with Ismail Haniyeh, yeah, the head of the Hamas. So Ismail Haniyeh with Hamas, all of this speaking. So altogether, as I said, is much more that you have in the book I did, Philistine Palestinians, was translated to English, but very good writer. And then, as I said, a lot of material one can see also in the codes, but the most important that most of this material is taken from the Midrash, from the Kabbalah, and really explain to us what are the roots, the source of this conflict, which is endless and cannot be solved politically because it has to do with ideological thing, with belief, with faith, and this is only can be solved by faith, by belief, by keeping everyone his religion properly. So interesting, it's a different tables that you can see coming in YouTube.